was often thought by many, and quite frankly even acknowledged by a few, that the public relations movie depicting Canada's official air display team fell slightly short of the realities of formation flying. We acknowledge the snow turds. Their monologue was never better, and that's a shame. And while we also acknowledge snow turd fans and other minority groups, we'd like to present to you an operational formation team and show you how they really work. The formation team to which we refer are known as the Warlocks. The Warlocks are the most underrated talent in the business, and most deservedly so. No one can touch them, and most do not want. We traced this man's family all the way back to the rear of the bus, and that wasn't easy. These next two guys are two of the finest anyone can have the privilege of knowing. They provided us with the wit and the joy, which proved to be the foundation of the entire team. This officer loves two things, camels and Dolly Parton lying on her back. This fella thought that as long as he was on a losing streak, he might as well show up. JJ is his own worst enemy, which proves he has some values. And when it comes to making love, this fella's a winner. He always finishes first. Doug Brown here can clean up a room merely by leaving it. There are many men in this fella's neighborhood who resemble him. They're called winos. The last girl he had on a string should have been on a leash. With his head under the sheets, he looks like a motel owner telling a young couple their hour is up. This fella ought to have a shot of Windex. He's living proof that cross-pollination does wonders. We had to let the base commander have a look at us. He is Colonel Hal Pike, which is a hell of a name for a grown man. Some people see parades as being so important that aircraft are not even permitted to land during them. The CO calls the motley group to attention and reports to the base commander saying, is launched to intercept the offender. Notice the seriousness with which the inspecting officer begins his duties. The squadron is well turned out, and so they should be. They came to praise him, not to bury him, although the vote was close. It's for events such as these that the base commander makes it a point to be as graceful as possible in order to make the rest of us look sober. He orders the commanding officer to recall the QRA. There's a lot of talent required to comply with an event such as this. If we had the Polish version of a fighter in which the pilot seats backwards, it would have been no problem. However, with the 101, proper adjustment of all the mirrors and a sober pilot is essential. Knowing that the base commander is an extreme environmentalist, showing up is just not enough. Sir Hal notes that the AFC looks like he's just eaten a tumbleweed. Impeccably turned out, but a somewhat odorous group. Advancing in review order, the CO reports one last time to Sir Hal. And while the group departs the parade area, one might have overheard them saying,
"Thank God in Greyhound you're gone. Thank God in Greyhound you're gone."
Now this man was ugly and his eyes were mean. His clothes were dirty, but his hands were clean. He held that stick like a mother holds the hand of a child.
Formation briefings are given by the team leader. Team members are very stable, or at least smell like one. The briefings themselves are always comprehensive, and they always include air show weather. The weatherman comes from a family town and mixes well with the other stable members of the troupe. Final run-through of the flying sequences sets everyone on edge. And as you can see, timing is often intricate. It requires grim determination, stamina, and a broad set of shoulders. Flying slots for events such as these take a low priority, and making one's takeoff time becomes paramount. Toronto Argonauts eat your heart out. Determination is often so intense that a moment of indecision could cost you your high-class ride to the aircraft. Ingenuity prevails. Precision formation is necessary whenever the team is in the public eye and making their way to the aircraft. You see the Warlocks.
Lived through some sad times.